Finally, World Ventures Travel Club will this week officially roll out their first World Ventures Foundation Service excursion here in South Africa. Each year, World Ventures, together with the World Ventures Foundation, run various programs, initiatives around the world. Tomorrow, approximately 50 Southern African-based volunteers will participate in making a difference at grassroots level, working with Botshabelo, a charity that's based in Midrand. Botshabelo not only runs a baby's home for abandoned children and those given up for adoption, but also focus on preschool teacher training. Joining us in studio to tell us more is Stephen and Tessa Khan from World Ventures. Good morning. Thank you for joining us, guys.
Hi.
Good morning, Evan. How are you?
Very good today. Very good. It's midweek and the cricket starts tomorrow, so, you know, I'm happy.
Wonderful.
I wanted to ask you about the various programs and initiatives that you guys are involved with and this charity specifically, if you guys can sort of give us a look in.
Great. Okay. Just thank you very much for allowing us here and with SABC. It's just great to be here. World Ventures and World Ventures Foundation are a company based in Plano, Texas in the United States. Tessa and I are independent representatives. We need to make that statement right up front, that we don't work for the company. We are just independent reps that volunteer our time towards a good cause. Now, 5 years ago, the foundation was formed within the company, and it started with building what we call bottle schools in Guatemala. And Hug It Forward, which is a charity organization, requested some of us as volunteers and members as ourselves. We have the people and the manpower, and they have the principles and the system to work. And that began World Ventures Foundation. So it's all volunteers that are representatives for the company.
Tell us about Botshabelo and the sort of interjections you guys are involved with.
Wow. Well, I always look at everything as how do I give back? And we were introduced to Botshabelo in December, where we had a braai, where we got together, we collected stuff to donate to the home. And we decided we wanted to do a volunteerism here in South Africa so we can give back to our people. And we went into Botshabelo, and I left my heart there. So what they do is Botshabelo look after children from the ages of birth to the age of two. They are abandoned children that are up for adoption. So they do a lot of that work. And I said to them, how do we give back? And they said, well, we've got another arm that actually helps uplift and educate children from the age of 6 months to 6 years. And that's where my passion actually lies.
So now with this sort of interjection, are you looking at maybe extending it elsewhere around the country, taking it a little bit nationwide?
Well, absolutely. I mean, we have representatives in all the major cities and all around South Africa. There is an initiative that is taking place in Durban. We have started this one here in Johannesburg, Midrand area. There's one that started in Zimbabwe last year because we're located there as well. So, yes, we'd love to extend this further around South Africa. However, we've at the moment identified 14 schools that are part of the teacher training program. And those are the 14 schools that we've earmarked for this year, once a month to go in and uplift and just beautify the environment that the school, the children can be in a better learning environment for growing up.
Tessa, tell us about Thursday. Tell us about tomorrow. Now, who will be there? Who will be attending? And what will be happening?
Okay, so we've got 50 members, representatives around the country that have come to us, even some from Zimbabwe, which is really, really exciting. We're all going to meet up in Midrand. We're going through to Botshabelo. What we're doing is we are building and painting and doing kitchens and all sorts of things. But we have got Carl Lowe, who's our international, expansion, in charge of Vice President. He will be out here. He arrives today, I think it is. And Matt Morris, who's one of the top income earners in the business, and he has a bestseller. So that's really exciting. So they're coming out. They're going to get involved at grassroots, do some painting. And what's even more exciting, I'd like to share with you, because we've got so many volunteers and because we've been able to raise so much money, we are going in, and last night a decision was made that we're going in and we're actually going to be painting a foster home as well tomorrow.
Well, that's fantastic news. Just to tell us about the funding around the project. How does it work?
Okay, so the funding is not coming from any organization. We, as I once said again, we are volunteers. So each volunteer has contributed a small amount of finances to fund some of the purchases that we're doing. But we've had people doing cupboards over the week. They've put kitchen cupboards in, we've put in kitchen sinks in, we've got a fridge that has been donated. We're taking the kids out of the school to Laurie Park Zoo, and they're able to give us a massive discount. And it's just amazing how giving people are when you actually put this out into the nation. It's just so heartwarming.
That's fantastic, and it's a fantastic, and all the success tomorrow. It's a real fantastic initiative, and hopefully you guys can take it around the country and really make a difference. Thank you very much. That's Stephen and Tessa Khan from World Ventures. Of course, they're involved with Bochabello, and they are doing fantastic work for the kids in South Africa. Let's take a quick and final look at what you are talking about on social media channel. You're watching SABC News. This was Newsroom, where we love it in the morning.